This is Dumbed Down Life number 79. Was DJ Lobsterdust with Epik Black Rock. There's always been a fine line when it comes to mashups because they're not strictly legal. They are taking lots and lots of bits of some well-known songs and mashing them up with bits of other well-known songs to give you something that's totally different. We've played several on Dumb Down Life, and we tend to get ours from mashuptown.com.
Hi, this is Scott Segler, author of the novels Infected and Contagious, and you are listening to Dumb Down Life.
One of the more famous English UFO sightings happened in a wood in Rendlesham Forest in Suffolk.
Near the airbase.
That's the one.
Yes, I know it.
And apparently the tapes, the recordings of the radio conversations that the soldiers were having during the incident have now been released under the Official Secrets Act or something or other. And they don't actually answer anything, which is fairly typical for any of these sort of released UFO sightings that the government or the military have. They never really actually expand on it, do they?
Well, I mean, part of the reason for that is the fact that they can redact them to shit by claiming the Official Secrets Act.
Yeah.
They can go, oh, this would be a danger to, you know, public or national security. That said, those tapes have been out for years, man.
Really?
Yeah, they've been around for a long, long time. Maybe not the entire tape, but certainly a good fair chunk of them where you can hear the soldiers talking to their commanding officer and stuff like that.
Wow, didn't know that. So that kind of really negates this whole thing then. Great.
Is this another one of those BBC stories that shows up years after it's actually been news?
Hey, did you know Anna Paquin got married? Yeah.
Well, according to the LA News Monitor on the 4th of November 2010, US military UFO sighting tapes released after 30 years. So
I would guess it's perhaps a less redacted version or something like that, or the full length, or because the tapes, although maybe it was the because there were British military involved as well. So maybe it was the British military tapes were released and the Americans kept theirs close to their chest.
And sorry, what was it? An American airbase in the UK, was it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. This is the thing that got me more than anything about the story was the fact that they make a big play of it being 30 years since it happened. And then it says it was in 1980. And I'm like, fuck, 1980? That was 30 years ago? It just made me feel incredibly old.
Kind of are now, Lance. I mean, you've got all the signs.
What, bad memory, middle age spread, joints are aching. Yeah, pretty much.
And bad memory as well.
Pardon? going as well. Yeah, apparently it was 1980, and in the dead of night, just after Christmas, the airman from the United States Air Force Bentwaters Air Base had investigated the suspected UFO landing. They went on to investigate an event in Rendlesham Forest near Woodbridge, Suffolk, where the suspected UFO landed. And the UFO tapes is said to have vivid account of what they found that very night.
Surely it would be the UFO tapes are.
Yes, you're right, but that's not how it's written, and I just read it verbatim. The UFO tapes is said to have a vivid account of what they found that very night.
Now, of course, it could be the fact that they're using the UFO tapes as a singular, because groups can be used as a singular, and then the correct is not are.
Thank you for that English lesson, Mr. Watson.
You're welcome.
But then they go on to say the tapes are accompanied. Oh, no, that works. Are accompanied, yeah, all right.
In all honesty, it's actually one of the more fascinating UFO stories out there, full stop, be it Britain or anywhere else. And I've seen quite a lot about it, and it really is a fascinating account.
Didn't they do a reconstruction or make a short TV episode based around it? I got this...
I hate reconstructions. You know what they do with reconstruction? Someone holds a camera and the director goes, now shake the camera. And that's it. They shake the camera and go, this is a reconstruction.
And that's something that really pisses you off as well, isn't it, Darren?
I don't like shaky cam. No. Do not like shaky cam.
You didn't like Blair Witch then?
Didn't like Blair Witch. Didn't like, what's the other one? Paranormal Activity. Now, the whole UFO thing, supposedly the governments aren't
too rushing to dismay the whole idea of UFOs because they like the...
They can go and test top secret airplanes and let people put it down to UFOs.
Exactly. Yeah, most of these UFOs are seen over air bases. Mm. This big dark triangle seen over an airbase. It was a UFO. No, it was one of the first U2 bombers, but we won't say anything. Yes, it was a UFO. Yes, well done. Mm.
Well, I mean, it's called misinformation. And actually, most UFO sightings aren't over air bases, but they are around airports and places like that. But then again, you know, I mean, it's like a Jacob's ladder almost. It's a never-ending thing. Is it a case of, oh, it's misinformation, they're telling us they're UFOs so that we actually think they're pretending they're UFOs to cover up top-secret aircraft, but they're actually UFOs, you know? Yes, they're UFOs, so that we go, oh, they're not UFOs, they're top-secret aircraft, when in fact they are UFOs.
What, the government and the military being honest?
Yeah, good point.
But the government and the military being able to hide something?
Yeah, good point.
In all fairness, they did pretty well at Area 51 with the Blackbird, the SR-71 and that lot. Although they didn't do so well with the current one, Aurora or whatever it is. Although, because, I mean, Airfix actually has a kit of Aurora. The government go, there's no such thing as Aurora.
Yeah. Well, you know, I think we all really ought to get that Airfix guy off of our project. Yeah. he keeps leaking the top secret projects.
I know, right, yeah. Building set models and everything, but yeah.
We tried flying the Airfix model, but we found at Mach 1 it broke up too easily.
As for those Lego guys, no.
Take a bite of the apple to feed the boredom.
that was Jensen Keets with Upgrade. You can find Jensen at www.jensenkeets.com. If you're not quite sure of the spelling, you can go to the show notes and get the links from there. Another show has been wound up, and we're really cracking on with these one-a-day podcasts. It's going pretty well. Do you think we'll make it to the end of the month? There's only one way to find out. Keep listening. Tune in again tomorrow. Ta-ra!